So, how's it, guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm coming to you from the one and only front yard because we're on lockdown. So, I want to do a quick video. A lot of you guys asked on my Instagram stories, you wanted to see a full walk around of the vehicle. So, today's that day, and let's show you guys what we've done to our overlanding vehicle, which is this. Okay, so first up, we'll talk about the bumper, front bumper. This one is made by Onca. So fully steel, got a place for a winch. I haven't got a winch fitted. High lift jack points, that's it. Why I chose this bumper is I quite like the look of this bumper. You do get them in a full loop, even with a mini bar in front where you can fit your spotlights. So this is something I would upgrade at some point. What I've got here now is A-line rims with 285/60R18 Cooper Discoverer 83 LTs. I would like to get a 16 or a 17 inch wheel with a bigger sidewall with a mud terrain at a later stage. For now, no problems with these tires. These go everywhere I want them to go, on road, off road, wet conditions. Love them. Okay, guys, so let's take a look on top of the vehicle. So what I've got is a Easy On K9 roof rack with a Easy On dual jerry can holder, Easy On 40 liter water tank, which I use mostly for cooking and showering. There's 40 liters that's in here. On the side, I've made myself some brackets, fitted the Trail Boss recovery tracks, only two recovery tracks. I've never used them before. The wind noise on this rack is not that much, but with the added stuff on top, yeah, it becomes like a bit noisy. So keep that in the back of your mind if you think of adding a roof rack with some accessories on top. Behind this, I do have a gas holder. That's the only stuff that gets on top of my roof. I may add some wood while I'm in the bush, but that's it. On the rear, I've got the Easy On Series 3 1.2 by 2.4 meter tent. Old tent, tent is probably 10 years plus old now, still in perfect condition. On the side over here, I've got the Easy On cube, opens up, folds out to the ground, pin it down, and then you've got your privacy room, your toilet, your shower. On the other side, I've got the Tent Co 2.5 meter by 2.5 meter awning. The reason I went with a straight awning and not a 270, because my tent opens up to the back, so that creates a little awning over the back of the vehicle, which is basically the kitchen. So I've got one straight there, I've got the cube on this side, and I've got the 2.5 awning on that side. Okay, guys, so this is a snorkel or a raised air intake. This one I got from 4x4 Direct. They fitted it for me as well. The suspension I've got in here, it's a Bilstein B8 shocks up front with uprated springs. At the rear, I've got standard springs, extended greasable shackles with air helper kits, airbags on top of the leaf springs to help me carry with the load, or to help me carry the load, the extra load that's on the vehicle. I've also got the Bilstein B6 shock absorbers in the rear. Okay, guys, so now we're in the rear of the vehicle. And yeah, this is where I get most of my questions. What's happening in the rear? How did we set this vehicle up to suit our needs? It's actually very simple, and it has changed a few times, just how we have changed in our way of camping and what we need and what we don't need and where to find what. So what I'll show you guys now is just basically what it looks like in the back and what we've added to make it more convenient for us. So we've got drawer system by Outback. It's basically two almost full length drawer systems. This is actually a drawer system that came out of the previous shape Hilux. I just custom made some side panels to fit into the new one. And what this basically does is, I've got one here. So this one basically takes all our food, two ammo crates without lids, goes into here. It takes all our food in there. At the back, you've got about a 30 centimeter space, and that carries our tools and spare filter for our trips. On this side, we've got all the washing basins. I don't know what's in here now. So we've got the washing basins, my Indiflate system in there, and all the cleaning stuff with one medic kit goes into that side. On that side, inside the gull wing there, anything that comes in extra that we may buy, even garbage bags, goes in there, that side. On this side over here, this one opens up like this. So that's got my recovery gear in there, with my gloves just hooked on here. So my complete recovery kit was in there. That's where the second battery actually was before I changed it to the back there. The reason why I changed it is after camping, and that's how we usually do this, or how we started to build this whole rig, is we go out, we camp, we see what we use, we see what we don't use, and we see where is wasted space. I'm a bit OCD when it comes to this kind of stuff, so I check and see, okay, well, I've got a gap there and I've got a gap there. We'll have to move something there that maybe we will fit it there so it stays there. And that way we use the space and we know we're using the space. So that's why I changed my battery from there to the corner there. Okay, so on this side, we've got the Stoffpot 4x4 drop down slider, fridge slider. So underneath that, I've got my fry pan laying there, always ready to go. Over here, I've got my connection for plugging in my fridge, cigar socket, and another voltmeter to tell me what's happening. On top here, I've got my water pipe. This is connected to a SureFlow pump that's in the back, in the corner there. Again, the wasted space, not wasted anymore. With my 50 liter water tank right in the back. I'll show you guys the water tank now. That's connected to the pump, feeds the ear, got water. That water we use for most of the time drinking. The other ones we use on top for cooking and showering. And we usually carry some bottled water with us as well. Let's take you inside. Let's show you guys the dual battery setup we've got running in there. Okay guys, as you can see, water tank, SureFlow pump, dual battery system. Behind this is the compressor, fully mounted. This is all space we didn't use. So this is space I utilized for these purposes. So I've got my compressor here, it's hard mounted. I can switch it on and off. Dual batteries in here. Here's my solar power coming in that charges this battery, as well from the solenoid that comes from the main battery. So what happens in here is I've got a little custom box I made with a fuse box, six-way fuse box. Got a 50 amp fuse, main fuse running to that fuse box, Lumino LED switches for my water pump, lights inside the canopy, and a spare one for the work lights I still need to fit. I've got a voltage meter over here that tells me the exact voltage on this complete system. Two USB ports where I charge camera batteries, cell phones. I've got a Ring Automotive 300 watt power inverter. This is specifically to charge my laptop. Then over here, we've got a Victron Energy Blue Solar Charge Controller, MPPT 75 watt 15 amp with a Bluetooth module. So I can check what the voltage is I'm getting on my app on my phone. This is my input for the solar panel. Just plug that into there. And these wires then run to my second battery here in the canopy itself. The other thing I've got in here, I don't know if you can see it, but I've got my little valve here which inflates my rear air helper suspension on the rear springs. It just, a lot of guys put it at the tow bar. I just like it here because my compressor is right here. And then this, what you can see here is actually a little drawer ammo crate or Wolfpack drawer system I built. Takes two ammo crates with the high lids where we pack our clothes in. So we've got two boxes of clothes. Yeah, that's the inside. So what we'll do now is I'll actually take you guys inside the vehicle. I see the guys wanted to see inside the vehicle as well. Okay guys, so inside the vehicle, Shaber, canvas, dash cover, tranny cover, seat covers, front and rear. I've got the Garmin, I haven't got the model name with me now, with the Trax for Africa SD card fitted into that I use. And I've got a DDPi dash camera. What I like this is it's not a suction cup, it gets taped to the windscreen. It's got a long wire that I can run through the roof lining, down the dorsal, through the dash, comes out here and powers from here, so I don't have extra wires running around off the dashboard. So all basic stuff. When we travel, there is a few. I've got two DJI Osmo action cameras which we put up various places where we need it when we go on trips. Otherwise it's stock standard inside. I don't know if you can see this, but yeah, this vehicle is actually signatured by Janiel de Villiers and Fernando Alonso. It's got their signatures on the sun visor. How cool is that? I'm gonna show you guys something in the rear now. So on the rear of the headrest on the passenger seat, I've got the iPad holder for the little one to watch a movie while we're on the trip. On my side, I've got a custom-made bracket that keeps my cameras. On the Land Cruiser, you get a top shelf where you can put your camera. On the Hilux, you don't have that, and you haven't got the headspace to fit that. So I made a bracket on the back seat where I can, with my quick couplers, I can hook in both cameras and they can stay there out of place, and if we need them, easy to reach. So I'll show you guys that now. Okay, so I don't know if you guys can see this properly, but it basically takes two cameras, one facing that way, one facing this way, sits on the headrest, and I can take off these cameras whenever I need them, and they're out of the way, they're not lying on the seat, so it works perfectly. So it's basically just a quick connector, take it off, there you go, there you've got your camera. And once it's this way, the other one sits this way. So that's all it is. So that's it guys, that's the walk around of this is a 2018 Toyota Hilux dual cab 4x4 auto 2.8, and this is our main travel vehicle, camping overlanding vehicle. And the thing I may have not mentioned is that this is also a daily driver. This is my wife's daily driver. Hopefully we can change that soon, so this can be a overland only vehicle. Guys, if you like this video and if you would like to see some more videos, or if you have any questions, drop them down in the comments below. Like or subscribe to my channel, and yeah, let's see if we can bring you more videos. Thanks a lot then. Cheers.